I'm here with Lea van der Vinde, curator at Mauritshuis, Barend Verheijen, creative director at Studio Louter, and Jeroen Luttikhuis, from the creative director at Opera Amsterdam. They are here representing the partnership that they developed for the project In Search of Johan Maurits, winner of the Museums Plus Heritage Award in the category International Project of the Year. First of all, congratulations on behalf of the Best of Heritage program, and thank you all for being here. Lea, my first question, can you briefly describe the project In Search of Johan Maurits for us?
Yes, of course. And also, thank you so much from us for inviting us to tell more about this project for the Best of Heritage. The exhibition Shifting Image In Search of Johan Maurits was an exhibition we organized in 2019 at the Mauritshuis. And it was a critical and a truly multifocal exploration of the history of Johan Maurits of Nassau-Siegen, and especially of the colonial history of Johan Maurits. He was the name giver of the Mauritshuis. He was also the man who had the Mauritshuis built. But he was also governor general of the plantation colony Dutch Brazil, and therefore his life story is also inextricably linked with the history of the Dutch slave trade, especially transatlantic slave trade. This exhibition was the first time the museum fully acknowledged and shared with the public this part of the history of its name giver.
How, what's the history of the project? How did the project come about? What were the, what was the rationale, the objectives, the aims? And please, Barend and Jeroen, feel free to jump in to help us understand better the project.
For the Mauritshuis is an art museum, and for a very long time, our narrative on Johan Maurits and also on paintings in our collection with colonial history was exclusively art historical. And we have been criticized for doing this in the last couple of years for not sharing any information on the history of slavery, for instance. Mm-hmm. Then in 2018, the museum was also attacked for the removal of a modern copy of a bust of Johan Maurits. This also had to do with this whole process of acknowledging this history and making changes in our installation and how we share this story. This was this came out to be a total Twitter storm with a lot of.
I remember that, actually.
So this was a very complicated time. Of course, the museum was severely attacked. In the end, we were also able to explain that we weren't removing Johan Maurits from the museum, but that we were making changes to share a more nuanced and contextualized story of Johan Maurits in the museum with authentic artworks. Mm-hmm. And this whole process and what happened in 2018 also resulted in the exhibition Shifting Image, in which we wanted to move further from those art historical perspectives and work together with a very large group of people and have a multi-perspective view on this complex history.
Yeah, because these things, they start. When was that first backlash against the museum? Was it 2018?
No, already earlier. After opening, we had a huge renovation and expansion project. And then in 2014, 2015, there were some opinion pieces, but also books in which activists and historians criticized the lack of information on Johan Maurits. And for making this exhibition, which was something we really struggled with, because we are an art museum, we are used to make exhibitions purely about art.
Neutral exhibitions, so to speak, right? Yeah.
So, and therefore, we partnered up with Studio Louter and Opera Amsterdam to work on a concept to really give way for those different voices to enter the museum
and to really confront the public. To confront this difficult past, right? What do you think, to anyone, the question is to any of you, what do you think were the particular qualities, innovations impressing the prize jury?
I think that what we tried is to make it really diverse, so to give many people with many different opinions a voice and not just one side of the debate. And the museum was more a place where everybody was invited to express their opinion and to go into discussion. So it was more a facilitator than the story maker. And I think that was really interesting about the process, but also about the visual concept. So we tried to make this quite literal and give diverse scientists and opinion makers the chance to give their personal vision on how they saw objects that were important for this story, to tell what they saw in them. So if you are a historian, you probably see a painting different than, for example, a biologist or an art historian. Right. And by showing all those diverse perspectives and giving the visitor the chance to zip, as you could say, between those different opinions, you also understand that different people from different times and from different groups have a different way of seeing their past. And I think what we also did is that we put this into a layer of facts that are important to understand what happened. So if you want to make your opinion, you first must know the facts. And I think that we really gave an opportunity to see what actually happened. And then you were invited to make your own opinion about it.
That's right. Would you like to add something, Jeroen, to this point?
I think what for us as designers, it was quite a luxurious position, I think, because the story behind it was really strong, and I think the thing the museum and Studio Louter came up with to really bring this into a multifocal, a multi-perspective exhibition, and asking more curators and scientists and people to have an opinion that gave us a very easy solution, actually. And we didn't really have to design it. So I think the design statement is not very large in this case. We simply made a sort of centric, very layered exhibition where the statue of Maurits was the centerpiece, and the objects, the paintings, were wrapped around it. And the only trick we did was we took them off the walls, made them sort of free-floating, and we brought a layer of sections around it, which were bringing a contextual backdrop. But the most important feature of the exhibition, I think, is the labels. And the labels were basically done with small iPads, and each iPad would have not one object label, but many, sometimes 6, 7, I remember. So you could the visitor could choose their own or swipe through all the opinions and all the perspectives on the same painting. And I think that was the big trick. And it was a very small thing, but that made the exhibition very special.
I agree. I mean, it must have been amazing. Unfortunately, I did not have the opportunity to see it, but the way you describe it, it must have been very powerful in terms of the message, the emotion, and the emotion it communicated, right? But at the same time, very not so much design, as you say. I find that very interesting. What were the What were the difficulties and positive experiences that you had during the project development implementation?
I think what was really interesting with this exhibition is that we, in the end, when you look back at it, at how we did it, that we did everything differently from what we would normally do at the museum. We worked in a much more participating way with a large group of authors from outside the museum, also internationally, which we normally don't do in such a way. But also, like Jeroen explained, that the paintings weren't hung on the walls, but on a structure. Digital text labels, we've never done that before. And to be honest, as a curator used to very traditional text labels, which are just printed and on the wall, these were things I was also feeling a bit insecure about sometimes, if this would actually work. And it did. It was really a very important part of the exhibition. It was very text heavy. There were a lot of texts with every artwork, but it didn't felt that way for our visitors. Mm-hmm. Because we had these iPads, you could just swipe through the texts and which weren't in any hierarchy. You could just go through them and read what you think is intriguing. Mm-hmm. And in the end, when you talk about the difficulties, but also the positive things, these were also very much linked. I'm a curator, and normally with an exhibition, I would write a lot of text labels. I would write a lot for an exhibition. Mm-hmm. And with this exhibition, I have truly, I stepped back and let loose some of this control you normally have on text. Because when you invite people for their personal narrative in connection to artworks, it's so important that they are also still in charge of their own voice and their own texts. So there was a minimum of editing.
Texts are a tool of power for us museum curators, right?
So I was a bit worried. I thought it was a great idea, but is this going to work in the end? And are people willing to contribute to this exhibition? But this whole process has been so heartwarming, truly. Almost everyone we contacted said yes directly. They really wanted to participate. And when the texts came in, it works all so perfectly. They were all together, they really gave a very full view of how you can look at this history of Dutch Brazil and of Johan Maurits, all those different perspectives. So it really worked out.
And I think it really communicated a very important lesson also for the visitor, not just for the museum, but also for the visitor, that it's important to respect other one's opinions and to be open for their perspective. And that really worked well here, because you saw all those different perspectives, not just one. You really start thinking about how important it is to be open to others. And it was the concept before, but it really worked. And that made us happy. Yeah,
again, I think it's so nice to see something working so well, not by designing it, but really the idea behind it. And I think design just contributed to it. It made it stronger, but it was not just design as a purpose. So that's what I liked it a lot. So you see the concept working instead of the design. And design is part of it.
Yeah. It's as if the positive experience came out from confronting the difficult issue, right? Yeah. So it's kind of, because it's our duty in order to encompass all those voices, which is amazing. Yeah. Final question, round of questions for all of you. Perhaps I would start with Leia. In what direct or and indirect ways do you think that this project had impact in the local community around the museum or even beyond in the mid to long term?
Yes, I think it's for the Dutch community and also the community in The Hague, it's so important that a classical art museum, this monumental museum like the Mauritshuis, really takes up this responsibility to share this in a transparent way, this full history of Johan Maurits, and don't shy away for different perspectives on it, also critiques, and really truly sharing in the museum this complicated history and also violent history of Johan Maurits. And so this is an important step for a museum to really share this with your public and also with your stakeholders. And then also transforming what you learn in the end into something permanent, because an exhibition is temporary and we've learned a lot, many ways, too much to talk about right now in this interview. But for instance, the paintings, most of the paintings that were part of the exhibition are now on permanent view in one of the main galleries of the museum. And now we have one dedicated space for every visitor that comes to the museum to understand where they are, what's the background of the Mauritshuis, and how are those paintings connected to colonial history and the history of slavery, and what's the role of Johan Maurits in all of this. So this is one of the many ways in which the exhibition has also impacted in the permanent museum, and therefore will impact visits from museum goers, hopefully also international museum goers in the near future for a long time.
And also other museums, maybe, yeah? As you say, mm-hmm. being where it is and being, it can influence other museums to confront their difficult past, because we all have them. We all have them.
We do.
We all have them. Yeah. Barend and Jeroen, what would you say would be the most important impact of a project where you participated and won this prize? So there is that too.
I think for us as designers, obviously the multi-perspectiveness, that was the big the big thing of this exhibition. But as a designer, it also opened my eyes a little bit, thinking about how museums deal with their voice in a content sense of in a content way, but also for me in a design sense. And what I think since we did the project, I started thinking about the role of labels, but also relations. So many people take it for granted that museums, they use the A, the B, C, D structure, object labels, subject labels, the exhibition titles, etc. And since then, we started playing with that as well. And I think that was a result of this project, thinking about what is the role of an object label, and why is it always this label next to an object, and how can we work with it in different ways, and also to try to connect to people, to the visitor, in different ways. So for me, it was a really important project, really an eye-opener, to be honest. Yeah.
Wonderful. Barend?
Yeah, for me, it's the same. We were all, of course, in the same process. And I think that for us, it was really interesting because we reflected on what actually the role of a museum is or could be in our current society. It used to be a place for learning, maybe, and for seeing art. Mm-hmm. Now it's also a stage for important discussions, mm-hmm. and a place where everybody should feel at home and should feel safe to express his own opinion and to reflect on other one's opinions. And I think that's really important. It's something that I didn't really acknowledge or realize until this project, that usually you just try to tell as clear as possible what you want to tell. And here it was really not about teaching people what to tell, but about offering a stage for other people to give them an opportunity to tell their story and to reflect on other one's stories. And for us, that's really a very a new vision on the role of museums, I think.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, but danked. You've been wonderful in the way you shared your experience about this project, which I highly, highly stimulate people to look for information about, including other temporary exhibitions about the museum, Mauritshuis, which is a wonderful museum. And I'm sure that they have been shaped so much by this project that they will have more contested stories to present, and it shapes you, right? It shapes the way you do things and the way you look at things and the way your audiences look at you. So bedankt, and hope to see you one of these days. Thank you.
Thank you so much.